effectively. It was a must-win for LA, down 2 games to nothing to a Jazz team that still has 2 games in the series. It's needed in Utah, so here we go. Game 3, keep in mind, Utah's so good when winning 2-0. Tyronn Lue, and here before, not his first rodeo. Not Joe Ingles' first rodeo. Utah shot the 3, they shot the lights out in game 2. They get off to an 8-0 start. Lue was like, hang on, we gotta do something. So they called the timeout, and whatever they did, it worked. Slowed the Jazz down a little bit, got that Clippers defense into a different gear, and that led to offense. Second quarter, PG-13, looking for his a little more. Behind the arc, he's got it. Reggie Jackson, he was dynamite in game 2, a losing effort. He had 29. He had 4 or 5, 13 points in the first half of this one. But Spider Mitchell and the Jazz weren't going anywhere. Mitchell was electric. He's been so great in this series. 35 points in consecutive games. Coming into this one, he had 16 in the second quarter alone. Next possession, Kawhi, the steal. When you see Leonard doing that, leading to that, you know it's a big game. Clippers led by 7. They led by 13 after George went splash on that one. Next possession. How about PG again? I mean, a ridiculously deep 3. Second game, he scored 20 in a postseason half as a member of the Clippers. LA led by 15 at the break. Third quarter, Leonard just taking this one over. He had 12 points in the third quarter, 34 points in the game, 14 of 24 from the field. Fourth quarter, in transition, Utah trying to get something going. Luke Kennard, the steal. And then Luke Kennard, what a weapon off the bench, splashing that 3. Utah pulled to win single digits, but they never really felt like they were going to make a serious run at this one. Mitchell landing awkwardly early in the fourth quarter there. You can see he didn't really want to put any pressure on that right leg. Utah saying, you know what, this is a long series. We ain't going to risk it again when we're down by double digits. Quinn Snyder and his team taking his medicine in game 3. Steve Ballmer and the Clippers got 34 from Kawhi, 31 from Paul George. We have a series again. 132-106.
You had to come out and play, protect our home court. The way Dallas came here and had their way with us, we knew we had to come here and protect this home court.
You and Kawhi played tonight the way we're used to seeing you play. What was different for you personally?
Myself, I just, just shoot. You know, just shoot. Don't worry about the results, just shoot. Shoot some more and shoot again. So, you know, I just came out to be aggressive, find my shot, and just stay with it.
You're right back in this series. What's going to be the key to tying this thing up on Monday?
Let this one go. Get ready for game 4. Same attack mentality. Play as a team.
You mean every bit of, like I said, a total team win. Our guys came out of the bench to bring PG and Kawhi. He set the tone. PG early, Kawhi late. And that's what we need. You know, my two best players to be able to do that. And set the table for everyone else, and they did.